In Italy, one way to deal with a total lockdown, it seems, try to avoid it. That seems to be the choice Italy has made at the moment, even after the country recorded its highest daily number of cases over the weekend. The Prime Minister, though, ordering new nationwide restrictions in response to this second wave. Bars and restaurants will now be forced to close at 6 p.m. local time. But when it comes to completely shutting down the country, Giuseppe Conte says, well, the country just can't afford it.
Managing the pandemic means to permit our medical system to give a prompt response, guaranteeing cure and proper hospitalizations to all citizens. It means to prevent a second complete lockdown like the one we had in spring. The country cannot afford it.
That's Giuseppe Conte. CNN's Ben Wedeman is in Rome for you. And you might almost ask, Ben, if Italy can't afford to lock down, then how on earth can it afford to stay open? It's not like they haven't seen how bad it can get.
Yeah, Becky, Italian leaders are really pulled in different directions. On the one hand, they really know that what is most effective is a really strict nationwide lockdown, the likes of what we saw earlier this year. Just a few days ago, the governor of Campania, where Naples is located, announced that that's what they should do, is a complete lockdown. And immediately, there were violent protests. On the other hand, we were up in northern Italy in one of the worst hit parts of the country earlier this year, where the doctors in an intensive care unit that was really the front lines of the struggle of against coronavirus made it clear at this rate things are only getting worse. The intensive care unit is a place of total concentration. No small talk, just the rhythmic beeping of the machines, the steady breathing of patients on ventilators. The Ospedale Maggiore di Lodi was in the front line of Italy's coronavirus pandemic earlier this year. And now, the staff is bracing for the second wave. Dr. Matteo Brambati anticipates another nightmare. It's like the second jump for a paratrooper, he tells me. The first time, you don't know what to expect. The second jump is more problematic because you know what's coming.
At the moment, Italian hospitals are able to deal with the number of patients in intensive care. However, that could change as the numbers continue to skyrocket.
ICU director Dr. Enrico Storti regularly gathers his colleagues for a debrief.
To better evaluate what we did and how we can now put on the floor and bring on the table our ideas, our solutions.
Gathered in this room are some of Italy's, perhaps some of the world's most experienced soldiers in the fight against COVID-19. Dr. Annalisa Malara diagnosed the first Italian coronavirus patient on the 20th of February.
We are ready because we learned a lot.
But this war, like all wars, takes a toll.
I think I felt like the soldiers during the world wars. I don't know. I think I experienced what these young boys experienced at that time when they were going fighting for a war, knowing that they could die.
The empty beds ready for more casualties. And this set of restrictions that Prime Minister Conte announced is the fourth set of restrictions he's announced in the last month. Many people feel that sooner or later, as the numbers continue to increase, and they're increasing dramatically every day, that Italy will indeed go back under total nationwide lockdown.